Woo! Good morning. Hello, how are you? I am back to tell you about the change of my channels. Thank you, following me. It's changed to Laughing with Luby. Now you can come along and you can laugh with me, you can laugh at me, either way. But I decided to change it because everybody needs to laugh. This time, doing this time right now in this country, we need a lot of laughs. So I decided to change the Laughing with Luby. So I'm gonna be on here probably twice a week with what's going on in the country, current events, what's going on in my life, and trying to put a comical, a comical spin on it. You know, so, and remember now I'm from the South, so you're going to hear a lot of, any ready. I don't know where I got that word from, but I'll say any ready when most people say anyway. But don't judge me, just listen to it. So I'm going to be talking about all kinds of things that's going to be of interest to me, hopefully to you. And then hopefully I can, you know, just, I know, they told me once that I had dry humor. If I could have done anything, I would have been a stand-up comedian. I can't stand up now, so I would have to be a sit-down comedian. But I'd have been a comedian. I think it is so hilarious to laugh and just let stuff go. We take stuff too seriously anyway, so we need some time to just let it go. So that's basically what I'm going to do. Because I'm going to be talking about things, because just the other day I was looking at the internet, just yesterday, and they were showing all the fall shows that won't be coming back. And I was thinking, oh my goodness, some of these shows I never seen. It only made me realize that I am a monogamous TV watcher. That means I watch the same thing over and over again. I watch the same shows. Some of these shows I didn't even know existed. I thought, well, I didn't know this was on TV anyway. So I like Naked in the Woods. Naked and Afraid. Anyway, these people walking around out there in the woods naked. I ain't nowhere in the world my bed in the woods naked. I ain't gonna be nowhere naked, not now. But I ain't gonna be in no jungle or dropped off somewhere and all them bugs and snakes, and then you gotta eat the bugs and the snakes. I'm worried about stuff crawling in places it don't need to be, because you know I got stuff that don't open one. So I'm like, no, I'm not being in no naked in the woods. So that was, I think that was canceled. The Walking Dead. Now I never watched The Walking Dead because I'm not into creepy TV shows. I kind of like would see the commercial come on and close my eyes. You know how you're watching something, you like one of them chicken people, like, oh, I don't want to see them, close my eyes. The bloody scene come up, you're watching the horror movie, which I don't think I've ever watched the horror movie. The closest thing I ever come to watching the horror movie is probably Boo with Tyler Perry. And that was the closest thing I come to. I don't do horror. And right here, in the Halloween season, you know, it's going to be a lot of horror. But I know that's going to be canceled. And so one of my other favorite shows, I do watch this, but I didn't know it came on TV. I'll usually watch it on Netflix. So, but I'm a monogamy TV watcher. You can catch me. If you want to know where I'm at on Monday, Thursday, and every night of the week, you'd know my TV schedule and you would know where I'm at. I watch the same shows on Thursday night every week. And the weirdest thing about these people, come close, is these people that know me, know I watch these shows every week, they're gonna call me on the phone. That phone will ring at 8 o'clock every Thursday. I'm like, now she know I'm watching this show. Why is she calling me? Why is she calling me on Thursday night? She know what I'm doing on Thursday night. Every time that phone would ring, ring-a-ling-a-ling, I'm like, thank God for on demand, or I'd just be pissed. So I let it ring, then she'd call right back. I'm not gonna help her know I'm on this freaking. So then I answer and I say, okay, I'm gonna sit you and talk to her because they got on demand, so I just go back. But then I'm like, I'm a monogamy TV watcher. You know I watch the same thing all over. I used to watch The Housewives, but I kind of got away from it because I got sick of them old women acting crazy. Them old, oh God, them boobies hanging everywhere. They always got them on display. They airing them out like they're hanging them on the line to dry or something like that. I'm like, oh God, it must be a wash day. The boobies out. Hang them out to dry. That just got old and boring. I'm thinking, do you have, I mean, come on, you're 60 freaking years old, or at least 50 years old. It's time to kind of ruin it. So I quit watching them because they got to be boring and, I don't know, just the same old thing over and over again. They can take one storyline and run it all season long, like the time they did with Lisa Rinna, the dog thing, where she says something about the dog and the Derek, which now got so much cosmetic surgery done. She was like, she's plastic. If you, I don't know if you, hopefully she don't get in no hot places, and Lord, don't let the house catch on fire, she gonna melt. So it is them housewives. I don't watch them, but I did watch Dead at Me or Dead at Something. I kind of like that. And I did do Good Girls. Good Girls was good, but I think they canceled those. So that's a bit talking about those and just what's going on in that department and just life in general. That's what I'm going to be talking about and trying to make it comical and trying to keep it light and not being all like, oh my goodness, today I'm coming to you to talk about it. No, we don't want to do that. Like I say, the holidays are coming. Halloween's the next one coming up. I don't care nothing about no Halloween. Like I told you, I don't like them creepy shows. So I don't particularly like Halloween. But I'm probably going to dress up in a costume for you. I might do something probably. But I'm not really crazy about it. I did it when my kids were young. You know, I do a lot of stuff with your mama. You got to take them trick-or-treating and all that stuff. Do them mama duties. I call them mama duties. But I didn't really care that much about Halloween because I don't like scary stuff. So I will not be doing a lot of that. But I will be on here talking about other things that matter to me. Like I said, now if you hear me say, and you're ready, don't be surprised. Matter of fact, I want you to just do a drinking game and say, we'll see how many times she gonna say "and ready" in this video. It's not gonna be that many because I'm gonna remember that, because I was watching, I think it was the news last week, and something had happened in Winston, and they were interviewing this man, his brother, and the brothers, and they have a tendency to say, "and you know what I mean," "and you know what I mean." I'm like, brother, if you say "you know what I mean" one more time. He did that interview, probably wasn't a good 5 minutes, if that long. And his whole interview, every other word was, "you know what I mean? You know what I mean?" You know what I mean? I'm like, what is it with the brothers and "you know what I mean"? Do you know what you mean? Then just say what you mean and quit saying "you know what I mean." I'm thinking, if you say "well, you know what I mean" one more time, I'm going to jump through this TV and I'm going to body slam you, because it's just too much to hear, you know what I mean. But I don't think they know my nose is on point today. It itching more than normal. I don't know if this, what is it? Maybe it's something coming off the screen. But so that was kind of funny though, that he was just, I'm thinking, oh God, and you know, they say we can't talk as it is. You're going to do it. I know what I mean. I know what I mean. But it's great. I'm going to get off here. I'm just letting you know, Laughing with Luby. I'm going to be hopefully keeping you comically entertained. Like I say, I'm not going to be writing any of my stuff. It's going to be dry humor. It'll just be plain old dry humor. Because I, whatever I feel, a lot of people say whatever I say. Because a lot of people just be laughing at me when I be talking to them. I be thinking, am I stupid? Or is this my dry humor? Or why are you laughing? Because most of the time I'll be 100% keeping it real and they be laughing. I'm like, you know, and so they're like, "you're so crazy." I'm like, I'm not crazy. I'm just, you know, this is the way things is. Sometimes my cotton head, I ain't combed it yet this morning, but I did pin it up in the back and ponytail. I think I'll get tired of being down there. But I'm going to go in here and make me some coffee. And I'm going to let you know, I'm going to see you next week, probably a couple of times. And I'm going to say, check me out. Laugh with me, laugh at me. Tell me some jokes. Give me, hey, tell me something going to make me laugh. Because I'm going to try to make you laugh at my humorous, dry humor. So check me out. Thumb me up. Let me know what you think. I'm going to holler at you. You going out and have a good day now. Y'all hear me now? Y'all hear me now down here in the country? Y'all going out and have a good day? I tell you, I am so country. I'm as country as white liquor. So you going out there and have a good day. See you later. Bye-bye.